Oh, I love you, David.
Oh, thank you, Don. I love you, too. Now, Don, all right, Don.
Yes.
But you should think about dropping some weight, you know.
I am.
How old a man are you?
I'm 59.
59 years old.
Yeah, I'm going to start now because we got such a dynamic card coming on March 18th.
Yeah, you're worried that I'm not going to plug the fire.
No.
That's why you're sliding it in now.
No, this is so big. It's not a worry. This is the best card I ever put together.
Okay, all right. Let me get to the card in a second.
Put the card aside.
Yeah, we'll
everybody going to know about his own paper.
Morty, we're going to put the card aside for a second.
Yeah, put the card aside.
Tell me about George Foreman. How did you become affiliated with him in the beginning, years and years ago? This was the Frazier-Foreman fight. Where did it take place in?
Kingston, Jamaica.
What year?
1973.
I have a feeling that most Americans, with due respect to Mike Tyson, I have a feeling most Americans would like to see George Foreman be the heavyweight champion again.
He will be.
You think he will be?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
He's going to knock out Holyfield. And then Tyson will knock him out.
You think Tyson will knock out George Foreman?
Yes.
But in a fight with Tyson and Foreman, don't you think most Americans will be pulling for Foreman?
Not necessarily so.
I think so.
Well, you know, you got those who are the aged.
Yeah.
And those who are old and going on. But those who are young and coming on will have...
And again, it has nothing to do with boxing merits on either side of the ring. I think it just is that Foreman is a better story right now.
Yes, he is. He's a likable fellow, too. Yeah. He's a lovable little guy.
Yeah. You know, lovable little guy. That's right.
The jolly brown giant.
All right, now, Don, take us back there to Kingston, Jamaica in 1972. Joe Frazier, George Foreman, and what happened?
Well, when I went to Kingston, Jamaica, I met George Foreman. George Foreman was running up and down a mountain over there training, and I said, George, you're going to knock out Joe Frazier.
Mm-hmm.
So he really thinks so. So every day we'd go and pick up members of his family. He's a very family-oriented mm-hmm. guy, and he has a large family, so he was going all the time, constantly. And I would go with him. Now, when I went to the fight, with Joe Frazier.
Who's the defending champion.
No, he was, yes, defending champion.
Yeah.
Yeah, Joe was the champ, and Yank Durham was his manager.
Right, one of the best.
He truly was. And so I went to the fight with Yank and Joe. And they put me in the seats over there in Joe's corner, you know, but I've been working with George all week.
Mm-hmm.
So now when the fight started, George hit Joe, and he started bouncing him around like a basketball,
yeah.
You know, up and down, up and down. So I started moving down toward George's corner, you know. The bell rang, you know what I mean? The first round was over. Second round, he started propelling him again. I got further over to George's corner.
Yeah.
So when he knocked him out, I was up in the ring with George. I said, George, I told you that you would do this. He said, yeah, you said that.
Yeah.
So I came to the fight in an entourage with Frazier,
yeah.
And I left in an entourage with Foreman.
Yeah. Now, you understand that that's weasel behavior. Even this audience agrees with me.
They don't like money. For those who don't like money.
So you're saying it's just business.
It's business. It's just, you've got to go to work.
Yeah.
I mean, if your ratings were going down,
what about
Joe, with you?
What about Joe Frazier's feelings during all this?
Well, Joe understands.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'd love him just as much, but you have to understand he lost.
All right, Don, let's talk about the upcoming fight. It's Tyson, it's Razor Ruddock.
Yes, Razor Ruddock. Oh,
who
by the way,
Razor Ruddock?
Paul, he's a Canadian like Paul.
Mm-hmm.
He wants Paul to play the Canadian national anthem, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
Old
he's
Canada.
Sending all of his things to Paul Schaefer, you know, that's Razor Ruddock, but he's going to be meeting Mike Tyson.
When? Where?
March 18th at the Mirage in Las Vegas, Nevada, mm-hmm. The Oasis in the Desert.
What is the purse?
The purses are going to be astronomical.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We don't know. We can never stop counting. Right now, what we're doing is we're going King Vision pay-per-view. This is the deal I have with Showtime and Tony Cox.
Right.
This,
this pay-per-view stuff, I mean, if you start doing the math on that, that's like $30, $40 million right there.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's just
what is Tyson going to get out of this?
His fair share.
And Don, what is Mike's fair share?
Well, Mike Tyson has a contract for $120 million.
Yeah. Oh, man.
So with King Vision, so he's got to keep working until he fulfills the contract and get his $120 million.
Mm-hmm.
So he will be making, he's the highest paid athlete in the history of the world.
I think so.
All you got to do is do his job,
yeah.
You know?
Isn't it true that you are also kind of managing Tyson and Razor Ruddock? Aren't you both sides of the fence here?
No, I have a lovely partner named Murad Mohammed. Murad Mohammed has Razor Ruddock.
Mm-hmm.
And I have Tyson, so we join forces together. Mm-hmm. And so now they're going to fight each other, and everybody's saying, why will he fight Razor Ruddock? Because Razor Ruddock is a tough kid. And Razor Ruddock is the number two contender. Tyson is the number one.
Mm-hmm.
So they're meeting to bring truth and integrity back to the game of boxing. And it's in Dim on the card, we have Julio Cesar Chavez fighting John Duplessis, and Simon Brown fighting Maurice Blocker. Two guys that grew up together, went to school together, godparents of their respective children, and now they're going to meet each other in the collision in the desert. Yeah. It's going to be super.
I have two things here to say. I think I could go the distance with Razor Ruddock. That's number one.
No, David.
Thank you, David.
No, David. We love you. We love you too much for that. Ain't no way I'm going to let
you
even get in there with Razor Ruddock.
Thank you,
Doc. You're an institution
thank
in our
you,
country.
But I can handle my own fights. And the other thing...
I like it.
The other thing, what happens out there at the Mirage in Las Vegas this night, April 18th, or no, that's Linda's play, whenever this fight is.
March 18th.
March 18th.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, it's Tokyo all over again, and Tyson is getting touched. Tyson is getting hurt. Now, will we see you do that, the famous Don King shift again? Will we see you go from Tyson's corner to Razor Ruddock's corner?
It's a possibility.
Appreciate your candor. It's Don King, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back.